somebody who cares. When I found you, found my most intimate prayer. When I found you, I found what every heart dreams of. When I found you, I found love. When I found you, I found the rest of my life. When I found you, I told all others goodbye. When I found you, I saw my fears fly away like a dove. When I found you, I found love.
Hi Danetta, today has finally come. I'm so excited and happy for you. I can remember when you first started working with us at Upward Bound. We took our first professional trip. You were on the plane in Puerto Rico and homegirl, you almost fainted. So you know me, I asked the lady to bring me some cold water and I dabbed your face and brought you back to life. But I'm so happy for you today. Oh yeah, I got one more funny story. Remember the time we were in Tinsley and you almost fell back when I caught you? Just like I got you today, girl. Love you and best wishes.
It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you.
Hey mom, this is your daughter Sonalia. I just want to say I love you.
Because you love me. You love me. This is why I love you.
Martinella and Clara, course, I want to say congratulations on your big day. I just pray God continue to bless you guys. And y'all just love on one another, and a love that is unconditional, that will last for many, many years. And I ask God just to just continue to and grow y'all love between one another. And on today, I'm glad to be a part of this day of being able to share with you guys. I'm so happy for you today, and I pray God's very best for you guys. Y'all just enjoy the love between each other. Enjoy your day.
Forever and a while.
To Danetta and Clarence, I just want to say congratulations to the both of you guys, and that I wish and pray that you guys have a long and successful and blessed and prosperous marriage, and lots of babies, not lots of nieces and nephews for me to love on, and that's it. Just wish y'all the best.
Hi there, I'm Pastor G, giving a shout out to my daughter, Danetta Flowers, and also to my son-in-law, to be Clarence, in about approximately 3 hours. I'm excited because this is the day that the Lord has made, and I'm rejoicing because what a better special occasion as to celebrate where two become one. It indeed is a blessing. So, Danetta on your special day and Clarence on your special day, just want you guys to know that I love you and we're praying God's best for your life. And I just want you to be encouraged that the best is yet to come. And we give God praise for all things. So enjoy your day and know that you're loved and that you're highly favored by God.
Baby, come walk with me, 'cause you've been away too long. I can live selfishly, and I know I was wrong. Oh, I embrace it completely. My life has new meaning, yeah. Baby, I cherish you, and I promise to love. Now it's crazy to me, I've been running all this time. You waited patiently on a love you would not find.
We'll be right back. us from
found love in you, and I've learned to love me too. Never have I felt that I could be all that you see. It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. Ooh.
behalf of the families of the bride and the groom, we would like to welcome all who have come out to witness this wedding. Let us pray. Our Father, we come before you on this holy occasion. And with our hearts filled with the spirit of love and thanksgiving, we praise and worship you as the giver of life and the creator of all good things. As we enter into this service, we are particularly giving thanks to you for this holy union of marriage, the most sacred of all human relationships. We pray for your presence here today and your blessings upon Danetta and Clarence. As they enter into this new life together, above all else, we thank you for Jesus, who gives meaning, direction, and hope to all human relationships. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. You may be seated. Who give this woman to be married to this man? This is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me. Danetta and Clarence. The ceremony of marriage in which you come to be united is the first and the oldest ceremony in all of the world. It says that God is the gift of marriage. God gives marriages to comfort the sorrows of life and to magnify his joys. Marriage is the clapping of hands, the blending of hearts, the union of two lives as one. He said two lives as one. You are no longer two. You become one. Says that your marriage must stand, not by the authority of the state, nor by the seal of your wedding certificate, but rather it must stand by the strength of your love for each other. Says that it must stand by your devotion to one another in good and in bad times. Finally, it must stand because of God's principles in your relationship. Marriage can be the greatest human relationship you would ever experience. However, in order for marriages to reach the full potential, you must allow God to play a primary role in your relationship. He knows your thoughts, your needs. He understands your heart and your love for one another. In fact, it was God who created the love and excitement you experienced for one another. We can easily say God knows you better than you know yourself. If you include him, he would help keep that delightful awareness of each other. It is often said that the idea of marriage is like an external triangle. You at the bottom and God at the top. And as long as you all keep your focus on God, the more focus you keep on God, the closer you become. I know that it's also said that there are no perfect marriages. There would always be situations that comes up. Again, say that you too become as one. Now, just as the body sometimes is as one, the mind and the legs are the same. Sometimes your legs will tell you that, your mind tells you that you can run, but your legs say, no, you can't do that. So you come together, the mind and the legs come together with a reason and say, well, instead of running, let's walk. So that's what you would have to do with situations and circumstances come up. You would have to become as one to work it out and figure it out. Say that all. Danetta and Clarence, as Danetta love Clarence, as your husband, it says also submit to him. Clarence, you have to love Danetta as your wife. And if you love one another, submit to one another, the grace of God would always be in your marriage. And God would allow again for you to work out any situation and circumstances that ever arise in your marriage. Finally, let me say to both of you, remember the external triangles. You all at the bottom, God at the top. Keep your spiritual eyes and ears open to God, the source of love, and the fulfillment will be yours. I promise, He will lead you into the pastures that you never thought that your life would come to. Take you the net of flowers.
Take you the net of flowers.
To be my wife. Look at her. Face her. Face her.
To be my wife.
To have.
To have.
And to hold.
And to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
For poor.
For poor.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
To love.
Love,
and to cherish,
and to cherish,
unto death,
and to death,
unto death,
unto death,
do us part,
do us part,
as God is my witness,
as God is my witness,
I give you my promise,
I give you my promise,
to never, my wives repeat these vows after me. I, Danetta Flowers.
I, Danetta Flowers.
Take you, Clarence Griffin.
Take you, Clarence Griffin.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have. And to hold. From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richness.
For richness.
For poor.
For
poor. In sickness. And in health.
Worth more than
to love. And to cherish. Until death. Do us part.
As God
is my witness,
my witness,
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
And my greatest.
Though small in size, these rings are very large in significance. Made of precious metals. They remind us that love is not cheap, nor common. Indeed, love may cost us dearly. Made in a circle. That design tells us that love must never come to an end. We must keep it continuously. As you wear these rings, whether together or apart for a moment, may they be constant reminders of these last promises that you are making here today. To Clarence, will you take this ring and place it upon her? That is left hand.
That I have.
Keep this promise.
Everything you think I have.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow. And with all that I am, and with all that I have, I honor you in the name of the Father and of the Son. And of the Holy Spirit.
So things,
amen.
But none quite as delectable as you. More beautiful than the Mona Lisa. Worth more.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
Just
and with all that I am.
And with all that I
have.
And all that I have.
I honor you in the name of the
Father.
In the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
You inspire me, inspire me. Don't you know it? My latest, my greatest inspiration. Thank you.
come together as family and friends. Those who are physically present, those of our loved ones who have gone on. We're asking your blessings upon these two lives and this home being established. You have made us so that we are incomplete without the other, so that we yearn for someone who we can love and whose love we can receive. We are thankful for the love we see here, and even more for the love we feel from you. May we never take your love for granted. We pray that your love will be a shield and a stay for the nettle and clients. When joy comes, may they share it together. When sorrow and regret, may they bear it together. In gladness or in tears, in sunshine or showers, may they ever draw closer to each other and nearer to you in the eternal pride. Grant them patience, gentleness, forbearance, and understanding. Protect their home from those forces that will break it apart. We ask for help, for long life, for the fulfillment of every good dream. May their love continue through life and smiling, blend into life eternal. We pray these things in confidence in the strong name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You have come before us and before God and have expressed your desires to be husband and wife. You have shown your love and affection by joining hands. You have made promises of faith and devotion each to the other, and have sealed these promises by giving of rings. By the power that's invested in me, I therefore pronounce you husband and wife. May God bless you, keep you, and give you his peace. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. You may salute the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Clarence Griffin.
Congratulations. congratulate my lovely daughter-in-law and my son, Clarence. I hope y'all have many wonderful years of love and happiness.
I'm happy for my nephew and his wife. What's his name? Janetta. And I hope they have a happy future together.
Make sure you get my good side. Congratulations to the bride and groom.
Congratulations, girl. I'm proud of you.
Congratulations, Clarence and Danette. I love y'all. Wish you all well.
Hey, cousin. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Danette. It was great. Everything went smooth, and I just thank God I had fun. Just gonna have fun the rest of the night.
I love you, Danette. Remember, you didn't used to like me? You didn't like me, but now you love me because I'm so opinionated.
Oh, yeah, congratulations to my big bro and my big sis, you know. Blessings. Blessings. Congratulations, you guys. I hope you guys have a successful marriage. Yeah.
Congratulations, big sis. It's recording or what?
Here we go.
Oh. Congratulations, little sis. My bad. Yeah.
Congratulations, Danetta. Love and blessings.
Congratulations,
Clarence and Danetta. We love you guys and we're praying for your marriage that God will continue to strengthen you and send people who love you to support you throughout your marriage. Congratulations again. We love you guys.
Much success to you all.
Congratulations.
Hey, we are so happy for you guys. I had a beautiful ceremony. Beautiful couple. Love y'all.
Congratulations, Danetta and Clarence. May God bless your union.
Congratulations.
How y'all doing? Beautiful wedding. We enjoyed it. Y'all looked beautiful. Magnificent. And the food, I hadn't tried it yet, but I believe it's going to be okay. Yeah, but that was a beautiful
wedding. Congratulations.
We love you guys. Hey, Clarence and Danetta, we're so happy for you.
Oh. You don't know, babe, when you hold me and kiss me slowly, it's the sweetest thing. And it don't change. If I had it my way, you would know that you are. You're the coffee that I need in the morning. You're my sunshine in the rain when it's pouring. Won't you give yourself to me? Give it all. I just wanna see. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I'll follow. No matter how far. Life is a movie. Oh, you're the best part. Oh, you're the best part. Oh, best part.
Is this sunrise and those brown eyes? Yes, you're the one that I desire. Wake up and then we make love. It makes me feel so nice. You're my water when I'm stuck in the desert. You're the talent all I take when my head hurts. You're the sunshine of my life. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I'll follow. No matter how far. If life is a movie, then you're the best part.
I'd like to send a toast to Mr. and Mrs. Griffin. Wish y'all many more of y'all happy birthday tomorrow.
Here, here, here.
Triple.